Hello, viewers. As you see, I'm wearing a color that several centuries ago I would have literally got killed for, imprisoned for, paid three times the price of gold for, and because of which I would have possibly smelled like a dead fish. Oh, and finally, it had something to do with the attempts to cure malaria. Caught your eye already? Let's begin! Purple is the one of the rarest colors in antiquity. The legend states that this pigment or dye has its origin in a tale of Heracles walking his dog on a tired beach. That's the shore of today's Lebanon. The dog chewed on a murex snail shell and his mouth turned purple. Heracles shared his discovery with King Phoenix and he decided that from now on rulers of Phoenicia would wear this color as a symbol of nobility. So, Tyrian purple became the most popular or unpopular color depending on which line of social status you were born. The production of the purple dye from the sea snails that were found in Tyre area was a challenging enterprise. It took thousands of murex mollusks to produce 1 gram of that pigment, which was slowly extracted from their slime. The odor was dreadful. The Crete citizens, Minoans, are said to have developed the industry-level production of the snail-based royal purple dye in years 1700 to 1600 BC. 100 years later, the technology spread to Levant, where it was finally associated with Tyre and Phoenicians, who were able to produce various shades and grades of purple. Keeping in mind all the above, no wonder that prices of purple dye were insanely high. Purple was associated with aristocracy, elites, deities even. During Roman Empire, only rulers could afford it. By the 4th century AD, purple became an emperor reserved color. Restrictive laws called sumptuary, from Latin sumptuarii leges, laws of consumption, concerning this dye were very strict at that time. Everyone breaking those could lose the whole property or even be executed. All notable Roman emperors wore purple togas. In the 1st century AD, tyrant Nero banned trade and possession of Tyrian purple dyes. All purple dealers' shops and businesses were closed. In the 3rd century, the cost of Tyrian purple was 3 times higher than the price of gold. The pound of purple silk cost 150,000 denarii and gold only 50,000 denarii. In the 4th century, under Emperor Diocletian, the state claimed a monopoly over the purple dyeing industry, wherein even an imitation of that color could mean a capital punishment for treason. The 6th century, the Codex Justinianus by Emperor Justinianus, who else, maintained to threaten illegal purple wearing with death punishment for high treason, as purple was reserved only for the emperor and his family. Moreover, even collecting murex sea snails became an illegal activity with fine of 2 pounds in gold. The 7th century is a time of Arab conquests that ended purple dyeing monopoly on the Levant, but it was continued by the Byzantine Empire until its end in the 15th century. Purple has also been a color of the church. The dusk of industrial murex snail purple dyeing was marked when, in 1464, Pope Paul II posed a decree obliging cardinals' robes to be purple by dyeing them with kermes, an insect from which the pigment was obtained. Middle Ages were the times when ordinary people experimented with various berries like blackberries or mulberries to make purple-like dyes, but those faded very easily and the color wasn't exactly purple, it was too reddish. In England, purple's exclusive status carried on till the Elizabethan era, which is the 16th century. The sumptuary consumers' laws strictly regulated which design and color could be worn by different representatives of English society. Only close relatives of the aforementioned royalty were allowed to wear purple. In 1856, an 18-year-old kid named William Henry Perkin accidentally ended all those millennia of royal monopoly. All that ancient past, pricier than gold purple dye, it all went to That kid, chemist, who tried to synthesize anti-malaria drug, quinine, noticed that the compound he developed dyes fabric in, yes, purple. He discovered and patented what is known as aniline purple. This synthetic dye, which, by the way, was the first synthetic dye in the world, was called mauvain, later mauve, after a French name for a purple mellow flower. William Perkin became very rich, didn't cure malaria, but his pigment was a cure for the social unfairness. Now everyone could afford it. New purple went rapidly into mass production. And since now you know all about this color, you probably noticed that there are not many countries that have purple on their flag. No wonder. How many countries could place a pigment 3 times pricier than gold on their flag? And actually, there are 2 countries that have purple elements on their national flags. It's our flag of Dominica, that has a Cicero parrot on it. The bird can only be found there, and this is a national symbol. And flag of Nicaragua, that has a purple rainbow. There was also a flag of Second Spanish Republic, but its life was very short, as the republic existed only from 1931 to 1939. And you guessed it! All those flags were introduced after the discovery of Perkin aniline purple. Of course, there are flags that are purple, but they are not national flags. Tokyo's prefecture in Japan is a good example. Now you know that even behind some stupid colors are thousands of years of interesting history ended abruptly by an 18-year-old kid with a test tube. I guess murex snails are eternally grateful for that. But it's not totally true that today Tyrian purple is for everybody. There is one item that still costs a fortune. It is Tyrian plum, a very rare British postage stamp from 1910. Rare because despite having been printed, it was never released due to the death of the King Edward VII, who is on that stamp. And because the whole issue was destroyed, only few stamps survived. You probably wonder how much such a stamp is worth, 110,000 pounds, which is about $135,000. Wow! So, in terms of colors, I'd be tickled pink if you'd subscribe to us. Till the next time, viewers!